the month of May.
Hey, we had some My Girls out there. I heard it. Oh, welcome to Lifeway Church. You made it. You made it. You made it to church this morning. Hey, I'm glad you made it to church this morning. I hope you're proud of yourself for making it to church today. Whether somebody drug you here, or you chose to come. You made it. You made it to church. Is anyone glad to be in church today? I hope so. I hope so. It's so important. It is so important. And we get to be together again. That's a big deal. Hey, I want you to know something. We believe your life matters here at Lifeway Church. I'm Pastor Jason, along with my wife, Miss Jamie, and the team. We're glad you're here today. And we want you to know something, that you're super, super valuable. And God's got some big stuff for you. And so I don't know where you're at in life. You might not even know where you're at in life. But there's a spiritual journey in life that we're all on. And we're somewhere on that journey. And we just want to illuminate that and help you realize, where am I at on this thing? And so we're here to help you flourish. We're here to help you take that next step. And so if you're in that place today, and as we're talking and going through God's word, you realize, man, my life matters more than I thought. Like, it's time for me to step up. It's time for me to take a step. We want to help you with that, because your life is way too valuable and way too important. Listen to me, to just make decisions based off problems. It's time to make some decisions based off your purpose. Your purpose should be way bigger than your problems. Can anybody give me an amen on that? Would you like that to be the case? It needs to be. And so find Isaiah right there. This is the next step. Pastor in the house, he will tell you what your next step is, even when you don't know what it is. No, we're passionate about that, though. And so we really do want to see you flourish. It's so, so vital that we do. It's time to start living on purpose, right? It's time we start living on purpose. I've been excited about this series that we're in called The Summer Slump, dealing with the lows of summer, because a lot of times in this season, which is supposed to be so relaxed, remember, summertime when the living's easy, well, somehow that easy turns into crazy, right? Where are we going? We don't know if we're going up, down, left, right. We don't know what's going on. Sometimes this season can just get so crazy. And when it's filled with all of the celebrations and pleasures and ice cream, you find yourself in this frumpy, slumpy place. And so we want to help deal with the lows of summer. Some of y'all are just ready to get back to discipline. Is anyone in the house ready for discipline again? I didn't think so. Okay, we got one in the house that's saying, get my discipline back. I want structure again. I'm ready to get back to structure where we know where we're going. And that's what this series is all about, is to help us thrive in every single season. And so I've been enjoying this, to just wake us up and say, how can I thrive? Because I don't want to just survive into the next season. I want to make sure no matter where I'm at, what's going on, I'm thriving. Like, I'm living my life on purpose. And we got something today that I believe is going to really, really help you thrive. I really believe it's going to help you line up with what God's saying to you and wants to do through you, where you're thriving in every season. I got a question for you, because a lot of times the lows and the slumpy feeling and whatever that is, the frustrations in life, they come from what's holding us back. They come from that feeling that something's holding me back. And so that's my question. What's holding you back today? What is it that's holding you? What is it that feels like it's pressing against you? What's that thing that's holding you back today? I got a question. Have you ever reached your limits? You ever reached your limit with something where you just got to the point where it's like, that's it, done. I have reached my limit. That's my limit, and I just reached it. You ever felt that before? Maybe it's something, maybe it's a relationship, maybe it's a position or a career, and you reach your limit. It's like, I'm done. I'm done with this thing. I cannot go any further. There's resistance there. There's a boundary there. I'm just done. I've reached my limit. We raced to Sioux Falls yesterday. My aunt passed away, and so we raced to Sioux Falls to go to the funeral, and we raced back home. It was crazy. We got up bright and early, took two of the kids, and just boogied the whole way. And so after the funeral, we went out and ate a little bit. afterwards, and my youngest daughter just reached her limit. I don't ever see, she's the one that never falls asleep. Like, we'll have a crazy day, and she's wide awake in her car seat. Just, Abby, you want to sleep? Nope. And we're eating dinner, and she just goes, we're like, that's weird. Like, that girl reached her limit. Boom, we just put her to sleep right there. She had reached her limit. That's what I'm talking about. Because a lot of times, we don't realize what our boundaries are. We don't realize what our limits are, but they're the things holding us back. Those are the things holding us back. We're going to meet a woman today in the scripture that had limits all around her. She had limits around her by society. She had limits around her from her family. She had religious limits, religious ideas that were limiting her and giving her boundaries. She had social limits. She had political limits. I mean, this woman was surrounded with limitations, surrounded in boundaries. And what she does, I believe we can take away. I'm gonna challenge you to take it away today. I'm gonna challenge you to see the move inside of this story that we're gonna look at today, because I believe it'll get you something. I really do. I believe it's what you need to thrive. You ready? Let's look at this. It's in Mark chapter 5. I wanna introduce you to this woman filled with boundaries and limits. It says this, that there was a woman in the crowd that had suffered for 12 years with constant bleeding. She had suffered a great deal from many doctors. Look at this. And over the years, she'd spent everything she had to pay them off. And she didn't get better. She only had gotten worse. Now, that's a scary feeling when you've spent everything you got and it's not getting any better. And she'd heard about Jesus. Now, can I just stop for a second? That doesn't matter at this point. That does nothing. She is so surrounded by limitations. She is so surrounded by boundaries that to hear that Jesus is coming through in her situation really doesn't matter. It's like, whoop-de-doo, he's coming through the town. Yay. That is a huge place for her that she can't partake of, but she does something amazing. Check this out. But she came up behind him and through the crowd, and she touched his robe, for she thought to herself, if I can just touch his robe, I will be healed. Let me stop there for 1 second. That's crazy. That's crazy thinking. Like, what is going through your brain? Are you sick? That's a crazy thought as we carry on. But immediately, the bleeding stopped. And she could feel in her body that she had been healed of her terrible condition. Jesus realized at once the healing power had gone out from him. Look at that. He noticed something left his body. Like, whoa, something just left my body. That's pretty cool. And so he turned around, look at this question, and he asked, who touched my robe? Now he's like famous, right? People are surrounding him and crowding him when he would walk. And so here's his disciples' answers. They said to him, look at the crowd pressing against you. How can you ask who touched me, right? That, like, how can you even ask that? You are being pushed around by the crowd. Let's carry on. But he kept on looking because he knew, no, that was a different kind of touch. That was a different kind of touch than how everyone else is touching me. Someone touched me on purpose. I like that thought. But he kept looking around to see who had done it. And then a frightened woman, trembling at the realization of what had happened to her, came to and fell on her knees in front of him and told him what she had done. And he said to her, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. I love this. Your suffering is over. This is an amazing story. See, we read this, that she came and fell at his knees, and it just seems like a response of reverence, right? You just kind of read that like, wow, that's a really cool reverent response for what had just happened to her. But the reason she fell at his knees is because she was freaking out, because the adrenaline just wore off, and she did something crazy. Let me tell you a little about this woman. She was sick, like very sick. She was broke. She was broke and there was no healing in sight. Like, there is no cure. You are done for. And because she was sick and because she was broke and because she was bleeding, she was unclean, which means you're quarantined. Y'all know what that means. You are quarantined. Stay in your house and do not come into public. Woman, you are unclean. Now, to be unclean in that day is a scary place. Like, you're dirty, you're sinful, do not come in public. Now we just see an unclean woman who's not supposed to be at her house. Not only that, but because she's a woman, she has no value in this day. No value. It's like, stay out of public squares. Don't be talking to a man. And for let alone, don't touch a man in public. These are the limitations around this woman. To walk up and just do this as a woman is crazy, let alone an unclean woman who busts through the crowd and doesn't just touch a man, but touches Jesus, the Messiah. Like, that's what that response is like. This woman was surrounded in boundaries. This woman was surrounded with limitations. And see, we just read through these scriptures and are just like, oh, it's a beautiful miracle. Next, oh, it's a beautiful miracle. Next, and we don't understand the seriousness of what's going on here. We don't understand what it took for this woman to reach Jesus like she did. We don't understand it. I mean, this was a crazy move with what she did here. She broke through some serious limitations. She's unclean. She should not be out of her house. What is she thinking? There's something in this story today. There's something in this story that I want you to take away. And here's my question to you. What limits you today? What's limiting you today? What has limited you in your life up to this point from touching Jesus in such a way as to get his attention? What's limiting you from touching Jesus? I'm talking breakthrough, go through the boundaries, tear down the limitations, and lay a hold of him in such a way that it gets his attention. That he goes, whoa, somebody just reached for me on purpose. Somebody just went a little crazy. Somebody got bold. Somebody just stepped out beyond the limitation to find me. What's limited you up to this point? What have you broken through to reach Jesus in such a way as to get his attention? Isn't that an interesting thought? Like, what limits you today? What is it that's held you back from touching him in such a way to get his attention? Because we're easy and quick to call ourselves followers of Jesus. Like, it's really easy, especially in our society, to say, yeah, I follow Jesus. I'm a Christian. Yep, got that mark on my belt. Yep, me too, right? You talk to anybody, you a Christian? Oh, yeah. But Jesus was so bold. He was so bold that he stepped out in front of his disciples and he said, you want to call yourself a Christian? You want to say you're following me? Listen to this. He said, then deny yourself. Deny yourself. Here's what he's telling his disciples. If you want to get everything that I have to offer you, if you want to experience me completely, deny yourself. Get over yourself. Here's what he's saying. Break through some limitations. I dare you. You want to experience all of me? You want to go beyond just saying, yeah, I love Jesus, but no, I experience him. I walk with him. I hear his voice. I listen to him when I don't know what to do. I look for his answers. I look for his counsel. Even when I think I could do it myself, I want to know his way instead. Like, you want to experience the fullness of me in your life? Deny yourself. Go through some limits. I dare you. Break down some boundaries. Do something crazy. Lay a hold of me in such a way that it'll get my attention. I dare you. See, what limits you from experiencing him like that? He goes so bold to say, deny yourselves and then follow me. Because here's what we've got to know. Here's what we've got to know today. That at the end of limits, at the end of limits is where you find Jesus. It really is. At the end of limits is where you find Jesus. And this is why, in such a comfortable society that we live in, we so often just bump up to our limits and go the other way. Bump up to a limit and just go the other way. But at the end of the limit is where he is. At the end of the limitation, beyond the limit is where we find him. Let me show you what this looks like. You got you, and then you've got these limits that we've set up, whether it's family, whether it's struggles, whether it's society, whether it's being politically correct, whether it's the friends that I've chosen to surround myself with. There's something there that we just bump up to, and then, oh, I guess that's it. I think I'm going to go up. Oh, I guess that's it. You know, I'm really going for it. I'm going to get God. I guess that's it. And we don't ever see him because we get to the limit and we won't go through it. At the end of your limits is where you find him. Beyond the limit is where you find him really, where he begins to satisfy all of you, where it begins to make sense, where the pieces begin to go together and you go, oh, that's why I'm on the planet. It's starting to make sense why I'm here. It's beyond the limit. See, we're blinded. We're blinded by limitations. We're blinded by these boundaries that we've created that many times we don't even see what Jesus has to offer. We don't even see him because we set up these limits. It's so interesting to me that if this woman would have gathered some friends around and just said, hey, ladies, can I tell you what I'm thinking? Can I tell you what I'm thinking? I think I'm going to break through the public square tomorrow and touch Jesus's robe. Girl, you are crazy. They'd have rebuked her straight up. Like, what are you thinking? What are you thinking? Do you realize you're unclean? Do you realize you're sick? I think the sickness has gone to her brain. Right? They'd have been like, are you nuts? You can't go in the public squares. You don't touch a man in the public square, let alone Jesus. Stay here, stay sick, and we'll just keep you on the prayer chain. You're crazy. But you know what? A lot of times the friends you pick do the same thing to you. Your friends are your future. If there's any young people in here today, write this on your forehead. Write it on your hand. TikTok it. Whatever. Write it down. Do something with this. Your friends are your future. Your friends are your future. Future, future, future. That's TikTok. Your friends are your future. Whoever you surround yourself with, you can deny it. You can lie it. You can do whatever you want. But who you surround yourself with is who you will become. Every single time. Your friends are your future. They really are. And a lot of times, the very limitations that we have where reaching Jesus is concerned is the group we've chosen to hang out with. It's the people we've chosen to do life with. And they're the ones going, just sit still, just relax. And you should be busting through the limits. You should be kicking down boundaries. You should be reaching through the crowd when it looks crazy, going, I've got to have him. I've got to have him. What's holding you back today from touching Jesus in such a way as to get his attention? Have you ever pulled power from him where he knew it left and you knew you got it? What are the limits today? What's stopping you today? Because at the end of the limits is where we find him. And we need it. You might not know it, but you need it. You need it. Let me show you this today. See, you might think you're waiting on a touch from Jesus. You might feel like, I've been waiting for years. I've been waiting for years. But here's the thing. He's waiting for a touch from you. You've been living your life thinking, I'm just waiting for him to show up. I've asked him 100 times to show up. I've asked him 100 times to help me with this situation. And he's saying, go through the limits. Push through. Don't let your friends keep you in this spot of just politically correct and contemporary. Break through the limits because he's waiting for a touch from you. You know, there's another scripture in your Bible that says this, draw near to me and I'll draw near to you. Who draws first? We do. Break through, because at the end of that limit, that's where you find him. That's where you find him. See, this woman we're reading about today could have stayed sick her whole life. She could have hung around her friends that would have rubbed her back and combed her hair and told her she was precious and stayed sick her whole life. And done everything that society was telling her to do and that they've laid up and the religious laws had commanded for her to do. But she did something out of the ordinary. She busted through the limits and she got what she was looking for. Do you realize if it wouldn't have worked, she'd have been disdained for life. She would have. It'd have been like, what were you thinking? Get her out of, like, go stay, make sure she stays home, please. She'd have been marked for life. What if it wouldn't have happened? How long have you sat behind that question? Well, what if it doesn't? What if it doesn't? What if it does? What if it does? What if it does? See, she's looking at all this fear, all of this fear that's staring her in the face of what could go bad. And she took the fear and turned it into faith. She turned it into faith and said, I don't care. I don't care. I need to know what's on the other side of that limit. I've got to find out. Have you sat your whole life and never seen what's on the other side of that limit? Because what if? What if it's Jesus? What if beyond that limit is the very thing you've been looking for? Because beyond your limits is where you find him. See, we think we're waiting for him, but he's waiting for us. He's waiting for you to realize that whatever it is I've set up around me that's so important and is keeping me where I'm at and is keeping me politically correct and just going with the flow and not making too much of a ruckus about the Lord, he wants to see you realize that he is more important than those limitations, that he is more important than that crowd I've surrounded myself with, that there's something more important than the boundaries and limitations I'm staring at, and it's him. I'm challenging you today. Go beyond the limits, because he's waiting for a touch from you. He really is. Somebody ready for that today? See, here's what we've got to do. I want to talk to you about this a little bit as we kind of rein in this morning, because it's so important. See, we live in America. And because we do, a lot of times we don't know what it means to be desperate. We don't know, most of us have never really been desperate. Most of us have never really been in need. I mean, maybe the lights will get shut off, but we got LED flashlights all over the place, right? Most of us have never really, really been in need. And because of that, we live our whole lives never knowing what it looks like to have a breaking point. Never knowing what it looks like where life has actually gotten beyond me. Like I'm at a breaking point. And what we need to realize today is that to reach Jesus in such a way to get his attention, to reach Jesus in such a way where I'm breaking through limitations, I'm knocking down barriers, I'm going beyond what looks like is holding me back, takes a breaking point. It takes a breaking point. And let me just tell you this today. It doesn't matter how successful you are. It doesn't matter how many things you have gained in your life. You're desperate for Jesus. You are. Your soul is crying out for him. There's something in every single one of you in this room that when I talk like this, deep down inside you, you're going, yes, 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 yes. I know it. I know it. Because your soul is desperate for Jesus. Your soul is desperate for that touch. It longs to reach him beyond that limit. But the limit just stops us. And we've got to reach our breaking point today. And so we know this, that Jesus is beyond the limits. That's what we've learned today. Okay, if I'm going to find him, if I'm going to reach him, it's beyond those limitations that I do it. And I don't know what those are, but you do. I know what that looks like for me. But what's that look like for you? Because that's where he's at. But here is what we need to do. We need to reach our breaking point. And so, what's your breaking point? What's your breaking point? How bad do you want it? How bad do you want to change? How bad do you want to know that, you know what, my life reached him, that I met him, that I went for him, that I didn't just sit my whole life and wait for him to show up in my lap. I went after him. I chased him down. I needed him more than anything in the world could fulfill me. I went after him. What's your breaking point? For some of you in here today, it might be straight up pride. You might be straight up prideful. And you are proud of yourself. You're convinced by yourself. And you are going your own way and you don't care It might be pride. And listen, if it is, then you need him to break you down to build you back up. And you don't admit that when you're prideful, right?
That ain't me. That's somebody else,
right? That's just what it is. Oh, that ain't me. But that's the breaking point. God, break me down. Break me down so that you can build me back up. That's your breaking point. Or for others of you in here, it might be broken like a horse, where at one point he was leading you and at one point he was guiding you, but you got to the point where you're just going your own way. You're bucking against the master, the leader, and you're just pulling against that thing, going your own way, and you're not asking for guidance anymore. You're not looking for counsel. You just go your own way. It doesn't really matter what he has to say. And that breaking point is coming back to the place of saying, God, lead me, please. I'll submit to your guiding. I'll submit to your leading. But if you want to reach him, if you really want to reach him, it takes a breaking point. It takes a breaking point. And I've learned this because God is such a gentleman. I think free will is one of the greatest things we have and one of the worst things we have, because it's free will. And he'll let you go your own way. He will. But if you ask him, God, break me. Break me. He will. He will. And it'll be the best thing you've ever asked for, because it'll sensitize your heart again to his whisper. It's a breaking point. It's going beyond the limitations to lay a hold of who he is. What's kept you? What's kept you from reaching him today? Here's the danger in this. This is why you need to find it. Because you'll never know your need for Jesus until you do. And many of you could testify to that in here and go, uh-huh. You will never know your need for Jesus until you do. And my cry is that you'd figure it out now rather than when it's too late. See, there's something so amazing about serving God where I can choose to reach him, or I can get to a point where I have to reach him because of where I'm at. You'll be reaching him out of desperation because of the situation. You'll never know your need for him until you do. And I'm asking you, don't wait that long. Break today. Break today. Go beyond the limits. Go beyond the boundaries that have set up. Go beyond whatever it is that's told you to stay the way you are, the way you are. And say, there's something beyond there. There's something on the other side of that limitation. There's an answer on the other side of that limitation. You'll never know your need for him. And so I'm going to beg you today and let you know. Actually, I'm going to have you say this slide with me. That'd be even better. Because I don't know if you know it, but deep down inside you know it. And so you ready? Say this with me. I need Jesus. Yeah, say that again. I need Jesus. Yeah, something in you goes, uh-huh, that's right, that's right. That is the truth. That is the truth. And that will always be the truth. And it doesn't matter what the limitations say. It doesn't matter what your boundaries say. That is the truth. It's the truth. And if we're going to live our whole lives walking up and running into a limitation and going the other way, we're missing that truth that I need Jesus. Him. I don't care what's holding me back. I don't care what's staring me in the face. I'm breaking through to get him. Like really, really, how much does it take to stop you? Is it very much? What does it take to detour you on your track to getting Jesus? Because it's amazing how we'll convince ourselves of other things, but we're kind of weak in convincing ourselves of this truth. You know what I'm talking about. When you're scrolling through Amazon, you can sell yourself like nobody's business, right? You can. If somebody walked up to you in the store and told you what you tell yourself, you'd slap them, right? I think I'll just get one, and if I don't need it, I'll just throw it away. You imagine if they tried to sell you that way? Or you know what, I'll just have three of that color or two of that color. We sell ourselves on everything else, but when it comes to this, we stop at limitations. I'm asking you today to break through them. Break through them. realize your need for Jesus. Realize the need for that touch from Jesus. So here's what I'm going to challenge you to do today. Reach. Reach. Reach for him. Reach for him. What's that look like for you? Reach for him. See, we'll sit our whole lives thinking that we're waiting on him. And he's waiting on you. We'll live our whole lives in frustration, in a slump, worn out, thinking we're waiting for him. He's waiting for you. He's waiting for you. Reach him in such a way as to get his attention. Reach him in such a way as to get his attention. Have you ever done that? Have you ever done that? Because if you haven't, you're missing out on what life is all about. You're missing out on what it even looks like to serve God. You gotta reach. And I want to tell you something cool about this story, just to give you courage, just to give you some strength, because I think a lot of times we don't know what that looks like. We don't know what it really looks like to reach Jesus. We don't know what that response will really look like, but this woman in our story today, she had so many limitations and so many boundaries around her that were telling her, just stay where you're at. Stay where you're at. And she wouldn't do it. She wasn't satisfied with it. And I love this thought because for her, honestly, for her, on the other side of this little thing she did, on this crazy faith, on this hungry soul, on the other side of that was disaster. It was disaster if it didn't work out. And she went for it, and he caught her. But there's something amazing about this that shows the character of God, because she was an unclean woman. She was unclean, full of sin, dirty, out of public, stay out. And when she reached up like this and she grabbed Jesus' robe or his garment, it's actually the end of his robe, which is so significant. When she laid a hold of that, do you realize she made his garment unclean? When she touched that robe, he became unclean because of her. And he took on the uncleanness and gave her health, gave her healing, gave her restoration. He took on her mess. He took on her sin. He took on her uncleanness on himself and gave her cleanness. And I love this. I love this because he didn't just stop there. But he stops to find out who it was, as if to embarrass her, as if to ridicule her in front of everybody. No. And this is what he does to us. He completely restored her. And he said, "Who touched me?" And this woman, realizing what she had just done, comes up from the crowd. This unclean, sick, broke woman, who wasn't even supposed to be in public, comes up from the crowd and says, "It was me." And he restores her completely by saying, "Hey, everybody, you, my daughter, are healed. You are whole. You are restored. You are clean again. Restore her back to public. Restore her back to society. Get up to your feet because you are somebody. You are somebody. You have value. Your life matters." And I love this. You are a daughter of God. And at the other side of that reach, at the end of that limit, is where he solidifies you. He brings you back. He lets people know who you really are. And he didn't just leave her healed. He restored her completely, where everybody knew she's good. She's healed. She's restored back to society. It's awesome. It's awesome. I don't know where you're at today. I don't know what the limits are that are staring you in the face. And honestly, say it like this, I don't know what's held you back. But don't go any longer. Don't go any longer staring at the limits, filled with excuses. Here I worried about what people are going to think if you go all in. If you break through the limits and reach him. Can I just give you that moment this morning to decide to break? Can we just take that moment this morning? If you would you just forget who's beside you for a second? I'm just going to challenge you today because I think this is an amazing opportunity. Maybe today could be the start of that reaching. What is it? What's holding you back today? I'm going to ask you if you're in this place and you need to be broken. Would you just pray for that right now? Just you and God. God, break me. Because it starts there. You got to find a breaking point. Because you're desperate for him. You might not know it, but you are. God, break me today. Would you pray that prayer? And let him break you. God, move in this place today. Move in this place today. With arms stretched wide, I know you hear my cry. There's someone in this place here today. You're staring sickness in the face. It's big. It's scary. And you never thought it'd be you. You never thought it'd be you. You thought you'd be invincible your whole life. And now you're staring something in the face. It's freaking you out. And I'm going to challenge you because I feel like God is challenging you. Reach through it. Reach through it. This is going to sound really weird, but what you think you need is healing. What you think you need is medicine. What you think you need is breakthrough. But it's him. It starts with him. It's not even healing. It's him. Go through it. Go through it today. Reach through and lay a hold of him today. Lay a hold of him today. He's not the giver of sickness. He's the healer of it. Go through today and grab a hold of him. God, whoever that is today, whoever that is, we stand in agreement with them today and say, let strength, let boldness, let courage rise up in them today to reach through, to break through that scary report and find you on the other side of it, God. Hallelujah. Let him break you today. Let him break you today. Go beyond the limitations and reach him. Hallelujah. You might be in this place today and you've lived your whole life on your own. You don't know him. You might not care to know him. Maybe you want to know him and you've never had the opportunity. But I'll tell you, there's nothing, nothing like living life with Jesus. There's nothing like it. There's nothing like it. It doesn't make everything go away, but it makes everything make sense. It gives you one to walk through the stuff with. It makes it make sense. And I want to give you the opportunity to know him today. It's the first step. It's the first step to breaking. It's saying, Jesus, I need you as the Lord of my life. I love to say it like this, that your life matters so much, you need someone else to lead it. It's too valuable to lead it yourself. And I just want to give you that opportunity in here today. If you're in here and you don't know him, would you raise your hand? I want to pray with you today to make him the Lord of your life, to start that breaking point. Even that might be the limit of breaking through today. You just say, that's me. I want to know him. Would you raise your hand in here today and just surrender that? Say, God, I need to know you. I want you as Lord of my life. It's the first step. It's so important. Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah. He's so good to us. Lord, have your way. Thank you. Lord, have your way. Give him your life today. In me. Have your way. Lord, like a mighty storm. Well, I want to pray with you today. If you're a believer in here and you know that breaking point is, if here it is. I heard it. I know it. I've been sitting on the other side of limits for way too long. And you know you need to break through something today. You know what that looks like, but I want to come into agreement with you to go beyond the limit today. Please, 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 don't live any longer on the other side of those limitations. Don't do it. There's way too much to be had in Jesus to stay on that side of limits. Go break through him. Reach him in such a way as to get his attention. Let me pray for you today. God, I pray for the saints in this house today that as we've seen such an amazing example of breaking through limitations and setting ourselves up with boundaries that keep us from all of you, I pray for your strength. I pray for the wisdom. I pray for our eyes to be opened, our ears to hear, to break through any limitation, to break through whatever boundary it is, to break through whatever it is that's keeping us from all of you, that you'd strengthen us today to do it, that you'd empower us today to do it, that you'd give us the unction and the strength to go through it and not stop short, God. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your precious promises. And we trust you today. Would you just say that with me today? Say, God, I trust you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, you can stand up with me this morning. Man, are you ready to break through some limitations? Is anybody in the house ready to break through some limitations? Let's do it. Let's be those people that reach him in such a way that it gets his attention. He is so awesome. I'm telling you, I can't say this enough. Your life matters. It matters to God. It matters to us. And it should matter to you. It should matter to you how you live it. It should matter to you what you do with it. It should matter to you what you do with it the minute you walk out these doors, because your life is so valuable. So I'm going to challenge you to live it on purpose. I'm going to challenge you to live it beyond limitations. I'm going to challenge you to live it with all of him. You want to do that? I know you do. It's awesome. But let somebody else know too. If you realize and believe your life matters, let someone else know theirs does too. Because that's what we were called to do. Amen. I've got sunshine on a cloudy day.